Our core project tackles the problem of building digital reconstructions of plants, plots, and whole fields. And for that, we are using robots, farming robots that could fly over the field or drive over the field, use their sensor data in order to build extremely high-resolution models of plants. That means we can build, for example, a 3D model of a plant, but we are not only interested in this 3D data, we want to align that over time, so building a 4D model. That means for every individual organ or even sub-organ resolution, we want to track its development over time and build a full digital model of the field as well as individual plants.
With our measurements, we for the first time provide data where we can really follow the dynamic behavior and the dynamic development of plants under their natural conditions. By, for example, finding the same leaf again, we can understand and describe how leaves develop in time, how they react to environmental conditions. We can do this not only by manual measurements, but by automated, robotized, intelligent approaches where the machines, the robots, can by themselves identify those elements within plants, within plant canopies, which are of scientific interest. The challenges behind there are, of course, that even though plants seem to be pretty rigid and they don't move away, nevertheless, they change their appearance, they change their structures. Leaves change their orientation, and also wind may move the canopy. So to find single elements, again, in the canopy is not easy, and that's where we need all the intelligence of the robots and of the software algorithms behind.
CP1 has achieved a lot of scientific goals already, so we are able to generate those 3D models of plants, we are able to register them over time and to track the development of the individual organs. There's still a lot of research to be done down the line. How can we achieve that with cheaper sensors, for example? How can we build more precise models? How can we better link this semantic information with the geometric information? And there are also certain things which are very hard to see with the cameras or with our human eyes. So if we use different sensors which look into different spectral bands, we are able to derive more information, things outside the visible spectrum. We have started with this work, but there are still a lot of to be done down the line, especially if we move everything out from the greenhouse into the field and doing this under real-world operations.